using mathematical construction to improve privacy. And I think this is a very interesting point. And if you look back in the last years, especially after the publication of the results of Edward Snowden's research, we know that we have a deep problem. The model we had as a cryptographer, that attacker is very powerful and will really store and modify every possible message, is really, I think so, the most realistic approximation about the situation. And we come to a point where we had to acknowledge that our government, if they are willing or not willing, not be able to protect the people for wiretapping from different organizations which are not possible attackable by the normal way we deal with problems. So it's very hard to sue, for instance, a foreign secret agency. And we have discussed it several times here and coming to a point which might be surprising for a lot of people, that one of the last defense line we can really establish is really closely to, connected to cryptographic algorithms, or as Bruce Nayer has made a nice quote, trust the mass, encryption is your friend. Maybe one of our last friends, but still working friend. So in which field we have taken the focus for our today talk was the idea to have some cryptographical techniques to improve security in a field where a lot of interesting mathematical and also practical problems occur. And we have chosen the field of elliptical curve cryptography. As you might know, it's a very interesting construction, and it's in heavy use in the field of embedded systems and in the field of personal devices, for instance, also the German Personalausweis using this kind of cryptography. If you follow my talks, you may know that I'm not so enthusiastic about elliptical curves as a majority of cryptographers, but I have to make once more the statement that some limitation of the shorter key lengths for elliptical curve might bring us to a lot of very challenging problems. For instance, the problem that quantum computers are much more powerful to attack short elliptical curve keys than long RSA keys have been mentioned many times. And in the last year, this was also acknowledged by some of the founder of elliptical curve cryptography. Nevertheless, if you go back to an old statement of Bruce Nayer, he mentioned that normally it's a good idea to use RSA if it's possible, but if no cryptography is possible or elliptical curve cryptography is possible, it's very clear that elliptical curve cryptography is the best use. And as I mentioned, in a lot of fields of embedded systems and personal devices, we have elliptical curves. And so our main idea was really thinking about using a pretty long time known techniques called blind signature, even in this field. And this is now the main topic, which is presented by my colleague Bruno Kirschner, which has written a master thesis about this. And to be very clear, we are just in a starting point. We have want to present some ideas and also some software, but it's clear that it will be a lot of additional research necessary to bring this to a good practical point. Nevertheless, I think we have done the first step in the direction.
Yeah, so thanks. First, let's start with a short reminder. What is a blind signature for everybody who never heard about it? Here it's the really the simplest version of it without any additional security options or whatever. It's just for to have a real world example. Took your information, a sheet of paper with text or whatever on it in an envelope, additional with a piece of carbon paper, give it someone you want to have to sign it, show that you are the person that you are allowed to get a signature, he will sign the envelope, you get the envelope back, take your sheet of paper, because you put a bit carbon paper in it. You have the signature through the envelope on your sheet of paper. Put it in a new envelope and everything's fine. You have a sheet of paper with a signature and it's valid. And we want to have something like this in software. Okay, one problem with blind signatures in elliptical curves is that all these blinding schemes have their own verification algorithms. So you can use typical ECD SA keys, but you can't use the typical verification algorithm. They all bring their own, and it's somehow a problem. You can't verify it through standard software like GPG. So how can we spread this? We need an idea, and it must be somehow simple to understand, like try to explain it. Blind signature is not dark voodoo. It's really simple from the idea. And it must be somehow simple to implement. We need to somehow take the OpenPGP standard and increase it with small idea, not big work, so everyone can implement it without tons of hours of work. So how can we do this? First, if you use it, you want to reuse your keys. You don't want to create a new pair, key pair for every algorithm someone wants to use. So just because someone says, oh, I don't like this blinding scheme, let's use the other one, you don't want to create a new key pair. And the other thing is, you want to use these signatures afterwards, like normal signatures. You don't want to check it. Oh, it's maybe could be a blind signature. We need some other kind of verification. Just say, check the signature, and if it's valid, you get an OK, and if it's not valid, you get OK, it's not OK. So how can we do this? We check the OpenPGP description, and this is just the typical tree format of the signature packet. And as you can see, there are three parts in it. You have the hash data in the upper part, you have the unhashed data, so additional information you can't verify, and you have the real signature data in the bottom. And everything is done with packages and sub-packages and so on, and we have the chance to just add one additional sub-package. It's not much, it don't break anything else, it's just one additional sub-package we can use and put inside this definition. It's the small one on the top right, the in color. So what can we put inside there? We just define an additional verification algorithm. So it's just an ID like preferred hashing algorithm, preferred public key algorithm, whatever. It's just the used verification algorithm. We can give these IDs by whatever we want. And if someone is checking these signature, it sees, okay, there's this additional package inside. We see it's a blind signature. We need additional verification algorithm. So if I can't verify it because I don't have this algorithm implemented, it's just not valid because I don't understand it. It's not valid because it's somehow broken or whatever. It's an additional information you get. And if you know it, if because you have a patched implementation, you can just verify it like everything else. Okay, so here is the output normally produced from GPT-2 list packages or list packets. And as you can see, there is an additional line of with critical hashed subpacket 100. It's somewhere in the middle. That's our new experimental subpackage we implemented with this critical flag. So if an implementation doesn't understand it, it will say, okay, it is necessary to understand this for verification. I don't do this, so I can't verify the signature. It's not necessarily broken. It's just I don't understand it. If I understand it, I can just use the algorithm ID at the end of the line. It's the number one. Use the right verification algorithm and check it. And maybe it's valid, maybe not. We will see. And because it's a hashed one, it's also secure by the normal signature algorithm, like all the other data, like signature creation date or issuer, and so on. Okay. And in the end, if the end user wants to verify a blind signature with this, don't have to do anything else like normal. You just can import the key or the signature and check it. And if you get an exclamation mark, everything's fine. No additional work, no additional programs or whatever. It's just the typical usage like all normal signatures.
(Clears throat)
Okay, thank you very much. I want to make some remarks for which social construction we can use this. For instance, think about a human rights organization which wants to give some digital certificates to their members. And usually there is a problem if you have normal public key infrastructure, there is a list of your members of your organization, a list of people you have supported. And as you may know, this is one of the most interesting attacking target by states' police actions. And so we are thinking about a tool set where you can really give away, for instance, signed identities without having a central list. This is all challenging. There are a lot of problems. We have to discuss it. We have to bring it in the organizational context of this organization. And we know that is not a solution of all problems. But I think it's a tool to improve really privacy on a mathematical understood level. As you might know, that the construction of blind signatures have been mainly pushed forward by David Chaum, and you may remember some protocols like eCash or also digital election using similar strategies, and we have really tried to bring some of the ideas into an interesting mathematical background and into an existing tool, and this was a very challenging and a very good master thesis about this, but one master thesis is not enough. So we asked the community to have a good look on our papers and a good look on the implementation. And really, we have tried to do our best, but I think we need some help to improve it. And I want to close with two things. One of the Edward Snowden statement in The Guardian. Crypto works, it's not a black art, it's a basic protection, it's a defense against the dark arts of the digital world. We must implement it and actively research it, and I think this is a request from us to the community, and it's clear everything is free and open source software, and you can find it on this Zero and Dorio GitHub repository. Okay, thank you for your attention.
Okay, there is some time left for questions. So if there are any questions.
It's not unusual if you give mathematical talk. And no, without take a look on it, we are on the first step on this journey, and yes, it's involving math. So if you know somebody which does math, invite him to attack our schemes. It's a welcome in that field. And if you do software development, criticize our ideas there, we are open for it. As we mentioned, we have tried to solve a lot of interesting questions and have really addressed it. But to bring it into practical usable systems, we need some help. And we would ask also very kindly for feedback from human rights or other political groups which could use really some of our ideas to improve the security of their members. Thank you.
Thank you.
Je mehr Formeln du hast, du weniger Rückfragen. Kirschner war schon da, oder?
Das ist
er.
Herr Kirschner?
Hallo.
Das ist schon, du bist ein bisschen zu früh, aber du bist flexibel.
Ach so, das haben wir schon vor.